Hey everybody, so I'm back to film my lip swatch video for the Milani Amore Matte Lip Creams. I am sorry this is so late. I mentioned these in October when they first came out, but they were a limited edition back then and they came out with 8 certain shades that are not available now, so I will not be swatching those. I never got all of those. I literally tried, I searched for months, and because they were limited edition, eventually when they sold out, they never restocked. So I only had 4 of the 8 shades, which I have swatches for you guys like on my arm to show you. I will mention a little bit about them in a second, but I'm not swatching those on my lips in this video. I have worn them in other videos, which I will link off on the screen right now and in the info box down below. If you want to see them like on my lips, I have worn them before in the past, but I'm not mentioning them in this video because they're unavailable to you guys now to purchase anyway, so that's just kind of pointless in a sense. So the first 8 shades were limited edition, and then they decided to bring them back for like permanent use. But the problem with that is that they keep coming out with new shades. I'm trying to like do a whole video with all the shades for you guys. And I bought the shades I'm showing you guys today online on their website because they have them all available. It's way easier than searching like CVS and Walgreens for them because it's kind of impossible, honestly, to get all the shades you want. They retail for $8.99 each, and it's pretty reasonable for what you get in my opinion. I do like them a lot. The shades I'm showing you guys right now are number 10 through 19, so I'll be showing you 10 shades today, and these are all permanent. The shades I'm showing you came out in January, and I tried to film this in January, but I had some audio issues, so I'm refilming it now. But since filming then, they came out with more shades. Now there is 20 through 28 available on the website as well. I do not have those yet. If you are interested in me picking those up to do like a part 2 lip swatch, let me know by thumbs upping this video or let me know down below if you want that. I was so blown when I saw them on their website because I was like, I finally have all the shades, and then you come out with more shades. So now I don't. And now I still have half because originally I had 4 out of 8 and now I have like 10 out of 20, which is not any better in my opinion. But anyway, so I have already filmed the lip swatches on an earlier date, so you'll see all of those right now, or actually towards the end of the video. I'm gonna put the wear test in first. That was filmed about a week ago, the same day I had some audio issues for this part of the video, so I'm wearing a different lip color, but you just get to see all the lip colors pretty much a lot throughout the video. And if you're wondering my opinion on them, I think the new permanent ones are way better than the limited edition ones. So if you have a bad impression from the limited edition ones, give one of these a try because the formula is way better in my opinion. The original ones were a little bit more patchy. They both dry really fast. I love that they dry to a true matte finish. But the first one was patchy. It was more drying, and even especially like the darker shades, like the berry shade, would always look splotchy. You could see each layer. You could see where it was uneven, and that was a little annoying to me. So these are way more forgiving. I'm wearing like one good layer of this red color right now, and it looks good. It doesn't look splotchy. It feels good on. It doesn't feel as drying. I can wear these and be comfortable. They don't flake off. They don't bleed. I don't have to wear a liner with them. I like that they're affordable. I think the permanent ones are way better than the first shades. I think they probably discontinued the first 8 shades because of that. And they came out with similar shades afterwards, so it's not like you're really losing much. It just got better in my opinion. So definitely check them out if you can find them, or just check them out on their website. I'll link it off down below. And if you're wondering, I get this all the time, what my favorite shades are, the ones I would highly recommend for those who have like similar skin tones as me. So I love the one that I'm wearing right now, but that is not technically one of my favorites. My 3 favorites are these shades. The first one being number 10. It's the first one I'll be swatching in the lip swatch section, and it is like the nudie pink. It's a little light, but I don't look washed out and dead in my opinion. It's nice and it feels really good on for as light of a color as it is, because it's very hard to find good nudes nowadays. And this one isn't too peachy, not too pink. It's just kind of like a good nude. So I really like that. And then the one that I'm wearing in the wear test is number 12, Loved. And this one is more of like a muted mauve with a little bit of red in it. It's kind of interesting. It just looks good on. It's like a My Lips Wet Better, but with a little bit more color type of shade. And then the last one in the lip swatch section, which is number 19, is the brown. And I thought this was really nice. I don't have a brown like this in my crazy liquid lipstick collection. And this is Coven. And this is like a nice medium brown. It's not too dark, it's not too vampy, but it's not too light that it kind of classifies as a nude. It's like a chocolatey, terracotta-y, caramelly brown, if that makes sense. You'll see it on, but I thought it was a nice unique shade, and I don't have one like that. So for the formula, it looks really good. I mean, there's a bunch of reds and pinks and berries, the usuals that you'll see in liquid lipstick lines, and you can check those out. As always, I'm not really a big fan of the pinks, but let me know down below which one you loved on me or your favorite out of the video, or which ones you will be checking out. So I hope you guys enjoy the video. Let's get started with the wear test and then on to lip swatches.
Hello, hello. So this is what we are starting with. It's such a nice even coat. Hopefully it stays similar to that. And it is about 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
It's 5:30 and we just finished dinner, so this is what it looks like right now. So I just reapplied, since you can see that it faded in the previous clip. It's about 5:50 right now. And oh, I want to show you guys, look how cute this is. This little panda, it's from Amazon. It's like filled with oil blotting sheets, so you just like rip off a sheet. I was looking shiny in the last clip and I was like, oh no, that ain't cool. So less shine, but yeah, oops. Look good again, applied, even after eating a bunch of seafood with Obey. So that is what it is.
Hello, hello. So this is the final look. And you guys saw this is the second application of it. It starts to do this little like thing. Well, of course it didn't exfoliate my lips and all that, but it doesn't run, as you can see. And there's no liner underneath. And it is about 7:20, I hope it don't include my teeth, 7:22 right now. So that's kind of how it is. If you're gonna eat something that would remove it, anything oil based or, you know, something that's crazy like that, but it doesn't like, yeah, it doesn't transfer otherwise. It's just if you get something oily on it and it comes off. So that is what it is right now, and I need to stop saying that because that's kind of annoying. I will talk to you guys later. Enjoy the swatches.